Thank you. Oh. 15 love.
It's a very good trivia question about Roger Federer at the Olympic Games. He's never won a singles medal at the Olympics. The great man has been to three Olympics, but he's lost four times in singles. Of course, he lost in round play, and then he lost a playoff for a bronze medal as well. Those Olympic events were on grass, and this is why so many people are saying that this perhaps will be Federer's time for a gold medal, perhaps his best opportunity on grass at Wimbledon. Out. That was Fire's chance, and he's going to go upstairs and have a check by Hawkeye.
The left near sideline, the ball was falling out.
So if this touches the line, he's broken serve. Very bad luck for the Colombian.
Two challenges remain.
And then we have another chance. Second net cord in 2 points. Gives Fire. Great chance for the second time in this game. Flat serve by Federer. Brings it back to deuce. Much slower first serve that time. Well positioned.
Advantage Federer.
Federer held, and so did Fire, and then Fire had two chances to break.
Yeah.
Yes, if you're wondering about those matches at the Olympics where Roger Federer lost four times in three tournaments at Sydney, he'd lost to Tommy Haas, the German, in the semi-final match, and lost in the bronze medal playoff to Anu Di Pasquale. In Athens in 2003, he lost to Thomas Berdych, who was playing here at this tournament. He lost in round 32. In Beijing in 2008, he lost to James Blake, the American, in the quarterfinals. But however, this man has an Olympic Games gold medal. That was in Beijing, where he and Stanislaw Wawrinka won the doubles for Switzerland. It's not often that Roger Federer would play in the centre court and at the empty seats, I think you'll agree. There are a lot of people in the complex today, but for most of the people, when you buy a ticket to come to the Olympic Games, you can watch the games on the outer court and also come in to a non-booked seat in the centre court. So people are outside and they may come in and when the match progresses further.
Correction, replay points. Mr. Fayez challenged the court, the left baseline, the ball was called in.
It looked out. We'll see in the replay. Well, it's right on the line. Right
replay
on the
point,
line.
15 all. Mr. Fayez has one challenging win.
This is a good service game so far by Falla.
40-15. Advantage file. Game file. game's on. Long. Again, Federer.
Very authoritative game here by Federer.
Federer leads by 3-2.
Building up, more people are coming in. It's a good matchup. Number 51 in the world, playing the number one. Nice day, and many thousands outside. And they are coming in. And really, it's a case of sit where you like it in most of the center court. And that's the other thing, a lot of young children in this crowd, too different with the Olympic Games from the crowds at the Wimbledon Tennis Championship, the All England Tennis Championships.
Time.
Of the national flavors that are in there. Sixth game, first set.
Hold
on, hit the line.
40-15.
Slight mishit nearby Federer.
Thank you. 40-30.
He can produce some delicate touches. Fire. He likes to play mostly on hard courts, so he says, but he's had some success on the grass, particularly this year. Of beating both of the marathon men at Wimbledon this year, just a couple of weeks ago.
Thank you.
Falla beat both John Isner and Nicholas Mahut. Isner and Mahut had played the that marathon match, the 11-hour match, 2 years earlier. When they came to Wimbledon this year, their hopes were dashed by a man at the far end of the court, Alejandro Falla. Beat them both individually in five set battles. Beautiful shot. That's a look inside his
30-15
personal box.
Watch,
takes the pace right off the ball there. He's setting up for the shot and then the change to the drop shot.
Again, Federer.
That's an impressive game for Federer.
Federer leads by 4-3. New balls, please.
Cell phone and the iPads. And to the right there in the second row, that's Stanislav Wawrinka, who's the gold medalist in tennis with this man.
Time.
The last Olympic Games in Beijing in the doubles. So he's come in to support his colleague and friend. He's in the lead here 4-3 in the first set. Remember, at the Olympic Games, best of three sets until the men's singles final. All other matches in the mixed doubles, and women's singles, best of three.
Fifteen love.
Federer with an open court to hit to.
15-0.
Okay, this becomes a big point for both men. This gives, perhaps gives Federer a solid look at the set, if he can take this to break point. He can't. So now there is a great chance for US number one Roger Federer. And he takes the break and a little bit of good fortune.
Net
court against Federer there. So serving for the first set. Federer takes the first set with a lovely topspin forehand. So set point now for Federer, three of them in fact. What a shot from Federer to take the first set, 6-3.
By 6-3.
It's the sort of shot people have come to see from Roger Federer, the number one player in the world. They say it's the most difficult shot in the game. We hear it over and over again. It's the high backhand volley. And a very good example of the expertise needed to play the shot. There it is. And away it flies for the winner and the set. Federer flying four times from the record of Alejandro.
Second set. Under fire to turn.
1 minute for the first set. Second set goes to
15 love.
Alejandro Falla. Maybe one getting the impression now that the Federer game in the near court improving the longer the game goes on. Falla's first serve is
looking
for him. He actually says his two-handed backhand is his best shot.
Game fire.
Solid game to open the second set. Holds to love.
First game, second set.
Just a short turnaround after one game of each set. Players don't sit down. So now we see Federer to come up. He's got the first set at 6-3. His wife watches from a very familiar position for her on this court. Federer hardly ever plays at Wimbledon outside of this court. It would be years, in fact.
15 love.
Advantages you get when you win the Wimbledon title 5 years in a row, as he did from 2003 to 2007.
Again, Federer. One game on.
Chair umpire is Carlos Bernardes of Brazil.
Let her service. Let her service. Long. Fall too long. 2 games to 1.
The other thing you might notice in the royal box at the far end of the court, not so many members of the usual British dignitaries, a lot of guests of the International Olympic Committee up there, and a guest of International Tennis Federation. Just to remind you, this is not an event by the England Tennis Trophy Club. It's from the International Olympic Committee and the International Tennis Federation. There's a chair umpire, the world traveler Carlos Bernardes. He's one of the leading sportsmen of the American nation of Colombia.
Time.
Serving at 1-2, but he has the first set in at 6-3. The two servicemen in the background from the army to bolster the security here. 12,000
15 on.
Ace by Federer.
Two games off. Thank you.
A child in the stands here. There is a sign that says no babes in arms allowed on the center in the center court. Beautiful point.
First along.
Yes, the sign says no babes in arms, which is interesting use of the English language, very quaint. In fact, I think that rule has been relaxed. Well, obviously, it has. There's some young children in the center court that I can see here. So, slightly different rules at an Olympic event. He's hitting with some good, solid ground strokes. Through this match, though, against Alejandro Falla, he's going to pull out the winner in the second set. So he's lost only 2 points so far in this set to serve on the serves. He's with support coming in. But just hit him and drove too long there.
Roger Federer is coming to call at the right baseline.
Don't often see Federer do that to stop him in a point. As soon as the shot was out, he appealed for it to be checked. And there it is. Just touched the line.
30 all. Mr. Federer has 2 challenges remaining.
Only one service break in the match so far. That came at 4-3 to Federer in the first set. And he went on to take the set at 6-3. 3-all with serve here in the second set. Tactic of the Federer game, attack early in the point. If you can get a break here, gives you a great chance to look at success at the end of the set and the course for the match here, being a best of three sets encounter. That's a winner from beyond the backcourt, so beyond the baseline.
15 all.
So nice play there by Falla. He hasn't hit many winners. For the first time in the match, with a shout of satisfaction. There's a real chance for Federer to put himself into a very good match position here. The break points. A couple of break points, and he hasn't dropped his serve in the match yet. Watching the Olympic Games over the next fortnight or so, there'll be really a crowd shot taken that won't have somebody tinkering with one of those things. Have all the apps with the result services and the coverage from parts of the Olympic Games, people using the streets, the trains, the tubes. Eighth game, second set now.
Long.
Falla really now. Sixth ace. As we all know, it's not a particularly fast big serve, Federer's, but always well positioned. Center.
Mr. Pius challenged the call at the left far sideline. The ball was called out.
So here's a challenge from Falla. Just looking at the gloves of Federer there, as if to say, what do you think? And well, it was well worth the challenge.
Replay the point, 30-15.
In that situation, it's a replay. Receive the ball on the replay, so maybe the call from Federer came from before the call came from Mr. Hawkeye. So here is Falla trying to keep his place in the tournament and in the match. Good work by Falla, saved two match points. And he's really up against it here. points against the world's number one. Joy about that in the Colombian backup team. Played by Alejandro Falla.
Federer lead by 5-4.
He was 3-5 down. He was love 40. He was facing, therefore, three match points against the world's number one, and he won the next 5 points to take the match and bring it back to 5-4. Can't daydream and let it unfold just because the other guy is the world's number one. He would have been dreaming about doing well for his country and for himself at Wimbledon in the Olympic Games. He's got to make it happen.
Time.
It's from the world's number one. It's a very good effort indeed by Falla. He's still pretty much in trouble, isn't he, with Falla about to serve. He has not dropped his serve in the match so far. So, it comes up the serve now.
Thank you.
He's into it, isn't he? He's won 6 points in a row, and that little sequence ends. There and went down the line in return of service, and now he's got 15-30. He's got Roger Federer thinking here. Now he's got great points for the first time in the match.
15-13.
Best shots of the match there from Roger Federer. Great chance still for Falla.
Let their service.
critical moment there. Bringing up the deuce if it is in from Federer. Let's look at the call here. It is just wide. What a swing in momentum it is for the Colombian. First time Federer has dropped the serve in the match, and now we look for Falla. Remember, he faced three match points. So for the second service game in a row by Alejandro Falla, it's love 40. See what he can do here. And it's too long.
So Falla
stays in the game. And the firing spirit of Alejandro Falla. And there's Federer pacing the baseline. He still has the break point. He still has the break point. Second serve, looking for 6-5. Second service game in a row, he comes back from love 40. Now has advantage. And for the second game in a row on his
5 points in a row. That from the mid-court, didn't he? Most unusual shot was hit straight at his torso. He's the right thing to do.
To take the set. Has been challenged by Federer. Fantastic turnaround in that set for Alejandro Falla. He takes the second set 7-5 and levels up one set each.
One set off.
Comes back for
points and then three break points against the world's number one. There might be some Olympic tennis officials feeling a bit anxious. They want Federer to be running a little deeper into the tournament than he tipped out in round one. Let's wait and see now. That'll be a one set played next for the outcome of this match. As we look to his boxer. Big satisfaction. Speaking people living up to his name. He's on fire right now.
Challenge for that one there in the third and final set.
That was well wide.
First game, final set. Mr. Falla has two challenges remaining.
advantage in this deciding set goes to Roger Federer. Remember that way back in 2004, Falla led Federer by 2 sets to love and then served for the match in the fourth set. But Federer beat him in the fifth. And a big tussle
Federer in his
career here at Wimbledon. So there was a very nice touch when the draw was announced for the Olympic Games singles here when Falla was drawn to play Federer. One of the newspapers headlined this matchup as the ghost Federer facing the ghost of Wimbledon past. And here it is right now for him, and he's having a good game here, isn't it, to open 2-2. You have the second game and the third and final set. Second set, Federer might have felt it was too tight or playing a bit with a bit of tightness. He seems very relaxed here at the start of the third and final set. Well, at home, do you agree? Is he a new man here at the start of the third and final set? These people will be hoping so from Switzerland, Swiss supporters. Alejandro Falla. He says his best tennis memory is playing Federer on this court in 2004, the one where he led 2 sets to love but lost in the fifth. Best tennis memory. Later that same year, in 2004, he beat Juan Martín del Potro. Open, so he's had some very big wins.
40-30.
Del Potro, of course, later won the US Open, beating Federer. Del Potro is here in this tournament as well, the Olympic Games.
Wait, please. Two.
Just a little bit of sun coming through at this stage of the match, which has been going for nearly an hour and a half.
And go inside. There's what they call a mixed media zone, where the media can interview the players straight off the court with flash interviews, short interviews, which of course is not done at Wimbledon in the All England Championships.
This is rather interesting. Fire still winning points. Federer's been saying in the last few days that being best of three, it's possible for a guy to get on a hot streak and knock over one of the top players, the top ranked players, which probably is less likely, well, is less likely to happen, according to Roger, in a five set match. In a best of five sets match. He thinks it puts the margins closer in the best of three. Very good example of that. Fire is still in this. His supporters are very keen to see this momentum continue.
Two games off.
team here to these Olympics. They're very football is their national game. And probably if you're thinking about Colombian sports personalities, Juan Pablo Montoya would be one name that might come to mind. Formula One driver, Carlos Valderrama. And maybe Alejandro Falla. Yes, Carlos Valderrama, a great footballer. Along with Faustino Asprilla. Tremendous footballers. Asprilla, the guy once played in here for Newcastle United and scored 3 goals, a wonderful hat trick against Barcelona. And the whole world knew about it. And they might get to know about this guy a little bit better the way he's going.
Okay, 15.
From Fire. Look at the drive into this shot. Right across court, a forehand cross court winner. It's a 40-15. Right, there's lots of subtlety still on the blade of Federer.
40-30.
This is a beautiful effort coming here by Fire. It's the world's number one. A man who's got this fantastic record on this very court. He's played 66 games on this court, has Federer. And he's won 59 of them. That's close to 90% of the time he plays here, he wins. Those other Colombian sports stars. I'm picking that the TV ratings back in Colombia right about now might be going through the roof.
Time.
Is he the ghost of Wimbledon past for Roger Federer?
Law 15.
Let's think again about the record of Roger Federer at the Olympic Games. has never won a singles medal. And this is his fourth attempt. Of course, he says he was a winner at Sydney in 2000 because he met his future wife there, so he claims that as a victory. Not quite so much confidence in that call from the crowd about loving Roger. It's heard regularly here. Well, Federer coming from behind as they hold serve here in the third and final set. There's the flag waving. But it's very tense. You can sense that, I'm sure, at home. That might be the first slip on the rather green lush fields here at Wimbledon. Change of direction needed. Just a slight slip by Federer gave Falla the point. He's going great things. Actually, the silence around the court is reflects shock here at what we're seeing. Oh, there's a miss hit down. A little bit of a couple of pressure shots down there by Falla in this game.
30 off.
Yes, this is a pressure now on Falla. It's almost like to put thoughts into his head that we don't know about, but it's almost like he's thinking, I can't believe I can win this. Oh, mind you, he can still pull out an excellent serve like that one, fast and flat. Produce. Prayers being offered up, perhaps. But three miss hits. In this 3 points lost, enforced errors I really feel by Falla here. And his backhand smash, not as powerful as Federer's early, and there's an easy put away.
Advantage Federer.
Four points down that side line, the backhand line, gives Roger Federer the break. The pressure really went on Falla then, and he made those mistakes. And Federer now has the lead, 4-3. And we celebrate these super slow-mo cameras. And the look of Federer's eyes riveted on the white ball. And it stays in for the winner. And a vital stage deep in the third and final set. It's the pressure suddenly swinging back on Alejandro Falla. Federer serving for 5-3. Excellent return.
Love 15.
Set. Point of the match.
Advantage Federer.
Just a wee look there at Stan Wawrinka up in the stands. He'll be playing with Federer. As Federer goes to 5-3 now. in the third and final set. There's Wawrinka, just one row back and on the right hand side.
Federer leads by 5 games to 3.
Beautiful point, but it's gone against Falla. Hey, the smiles are coming back at Wimbledon. There was a silence when the pressure was on the world's number one, but not anymore with winners like that. And the glare from Federer at his opponent. It's not over yet. This is the third batch of critical points against Falla. Three were match points, three were break points. He got out of those. Can he get out of this set of match points? Well, you be the judge.
15-14.
He's in a really tight spot now, but he's contributed so much to this match as the 28-year-old Alejandro Falla. But it's still match point against him. What a lovely touch by a pretty relaxed Federer, perhaps. As he takes the match, and you can see a measure of relief in the 6-3, 5-7, 6-3 win to Federer over Falla. And a very nice exchange at the net between the two. And I think Federer might agree it was a pretty good test for him round one, as he tries to win an Olympic singles gold medal for the first time. Confirmed result there, 6-3, 5-7, 6-3. And just a further measure of the grace of Federer, who waited and will leave the courts with his vanquished opponent, who gave so much for the match, Alejandro Falla of Colombia.